What's up? Hello, I'm GlitchCat. This is a tutorial for Sawrfing Castle from Quickie World. First thing I'm going to do is just play it through so you can see it done normally, and the inputs are going to be in the upper left. Orb. So there's a lot to absorb here, and I'm going to start at the beginning and get into some more detail about the different strats for this level. This is just a video, by the way. So the first thing is the move up onto the rope right there. And back it up just a little bit so we can see it from the start. So the first thing you can do to really, really help yourself out in this level is just do a standing jump. That you're already just standing right here. You don't have to move at all at the start. And that saw is just going to swoop in underneath you. So you don't even need to move. And you can just ricochet yourself right up to the rope up here. And then you can just start your run. That has a lot of benefits because you're not... I see a lot of people trying to maybe catch it in the air or something. Or try to kind of mid-air it. You don't have to do that at all. You can just get it right off the ground. So, moving ahead a little bit. Right here. This landing. I really, really want to mention this. When you're surfing on a saw, this highlighted blue area, this is the area that you actually want to pay attention to. And I'll move this back just a little bit so you can actually see. Okay, so it doesn't really matter where Mario is, but just take a look at the saw itself. Where are we? This little blue area. The little core is what you really want to be paying attention to in the saw. If you're aiming for the side edges of it, you're probably going to fall through. So don't look at the whole image of the saw as a circle. Just focus on this little blue core right in here. And that'll help you out a lot with this landing. Helpful thing, count the number of jumps that you're doing. You don't even need to boost yourself through that section. You're just kind of 1, 2, 3, 4. And you go right up. Paying attention to the number of spin jumps in a lot of spin surfing sections is always pretty helpful. So then we get to this part. Yeah, that happens pretty quick. Take another look at it. A couple of really important things to note here. Wait, hang on. Too much rewinding. All right. First thing. Landing on the block is preferable to landing on either side of it because there's this weird delay when you try to pick it up sometimes, and it can screw with your position if you're trying to come in from the horizontal. So just try to drop down on top of it, and that'll make the pickup a lot easier. Second thing is position away from this rotating block right here. You don't want to be right up against it. If you're standing there, there's a chance that the grab block that you're throwing will just break. And you won't even get through the gate at all. So try to maintain a little bit of distance right here. You know, a Bob Ross amount. Just a happy little amount. And you can see that in the throw. I'm doing it from a whole block away right here. So try to position yourself with some space there. And it'll make that gate easier to get through. And moving on. I'm kind of watching this with y'all. Well, let's see here. So yeah, same thing here, aiming for the core instead of for the sides and just kind of anticipating that and trying to stay above it. You can imagine that there's a little square, right? Just try to stay inside this little blue square whenever you're surfing. Don't look too far ahead of yourself or don't try to linger too far in the back. So I haven't really heard people talk a lot about this obstacle being incredibly difficult, but there is one thing you can do to really help yourself out, which is that you never actually have to stop holding X and A up here, and you can see it on the D-pad. Once you pick up the grab block and you just start spinning again, it's easier to do that by just pressing X to pick up the grab block and then surfing back with A. So now you're holding X and A for speed, and you're just surfing on the saw with A. And so you never actually have to let go of that, even when you have the shell. And all you have to do is come up from beneath the shell to ensure the grab. You don't want to be coming at it from the side because you risk poofing it with the spin jump. So just lift up from below it in this way. That kind of lift. Right? Yeah, right there. See that lift? Just like that. But now you're still holding X, right? You're holding X to keep a hold of the shell that you just grabbed. And you're surfing through, and then you get to this. And this is, I think, what gives people a lot of trouble, and I hear people asking about frequently. This is just a sort of re-grab. Don't worry, just go quick, get ahead of it. Move, when you're in this position, don't hang back. Get that little bird shape off the screen. Don't hang back when you're here, because you'll spawn the fireballs weird. Get into this space quickly and just be ready to anticipate these two. But if you do that, you should get well enough ahead of the saw. There's a distance here. Notice the saw is already way back, and I'm already moving ahead into this space. That's good. That's what you want, because that gives you a couple of options. Some people go way up high from this, and some people tend to go down low. But what I found to be the most effective is from this position coming off of that fireball regrab is to do the thing and aim for the coin, but actually aim a little bit to the inside of that jump. Because what that's going to do is allow the shell to pass through you. If you're spinning and you end up throwing the shell the wrong way, it's just going to hit this wall and rebound. And if you're close enough to the wall in this kind of safe zone, it's not going to actually hurt you. And that's going to just free up your mind and let you focus on actually landing on the saw in this spot. And see that happen? Okay, sorry, that was kind of bumpy. Coming into it, dropping low. Now that time I got the right facing shell toss, but it's cool because I was in a space that would have been protected by the proximity to the wall. Hang on, we're getting to the green shell jump. Are you caught up so far? Are you good? Are you feeling all right? Do you need a snack or anything? Get up and get one. Now's the time. Let's all go to the lobby, and then we'll learn about the shell trick. I'm just kidding. Let's do it now. Or you could just pause the video, you know. So shell time. Still holding... Well, okay, we were holding X and A throughout this whole section. Remember we were talking about holding X and A through the whole level? You can still do that here. You can just release X to throw the shell, and now you're still on A to do the spin jump. But now is the time in the level when you actually do need to switch over to Y and B, because we need to do a regular jump off the green shell. And so let's just like watch it. There it is. Now first of all, that down input is just accidental. You don't need to do a down input here. My controller slipped when I recorded this little video. Doesn't matter. This is just a shell jump, and I feel like I could do a shell jump video, but everybody kind of gets it. Just aim and do a shell jump. But the thing that you can do to really help yourself out, if you find that you're moving a little slow, remember, because we're watching this saw, because we want to catch up with it down here. And if you find that this saw is a little bit ahead and you're having to rush to catch up with it, what you can do is just minimize slow fall. When you're getting over the spike wall here, just don't hold jump. See, I'm only holding X, or well, Y right now, but run in any case. And that will just make you fall faster and get on this platform a little bit faster down here. I know these are great illustrations, right? But you'll get on the platform a little faster and be a little bit safer, and you'll be able to catch up to the saw, because actually this space in here has a lot of leniency, provided that you just kind of get to this platform with the saw in generally this big blue area. There's a cold front coming in over Western Mushroom Kingdom this week. Anyhow, jumps. Let's back it up and watch it again. So here's the thing. Again, aim for the core. Here's the core. Where's the core? Here's the core of the saw. Remember to aim for that core and not the edges of it. And then when you jump, remember that you don't have to make a lot of crazy, tricky movements. You don't have to go like, woo, like all around like that. You can just go, where are we? Okay, coming in like this. No, coming in from here. You can just go kind of straight up, right? And just, hang on. I know, I swear this is accurate. Yeah, I'm just moving in the opposite direction because I don't know how to distinguish left from right. Where are we? Yeah. You don't have to make a lot of big arcs with your jump in this section because the saws are going to be moving around you. So all you really need to do is just kind of go up. You don't have to worry about jumping or making some kind of big swinging motion. Just go up, and this saw is going to move into a favorable position. Yeah. Get that? Here's the whole thing again. Just an easy arc. Not a big leap. Just make a nice pop. Just pop off, you know? You're at the end. You're almost at the end of the level. You can pop off. Aiming for the core. And then this little guy. Here's the thing. This guy is tricky. Don't look at him. He's down here. He's waiting for you. He's kind of grumpy. See there? That's him. He's being grumpy down here. Don't look at him. Don't worry about it. Just try to get yourself into this spot in the air. That's what you can focus on as you're moving through the regrab section here. You don't even really need to regrab. You're moving through this little surf, and you're just sort of staying above it. Once you get to this point, like, just look up here. Don't worry about this guy. Don't worry about what he's going to do or trying to figure out his trajectory or anything. Just get into this spot. You can use the background to kind of help yourself out. There's this little brick right here and this texture in the wall back there that might work. But just don't worry about him, right? That's the secret. Just don't even worry. And again, oh, sorry, the video is apparently... And then glitch and go into a warp zone, of course. But during this, again, the same thing that you did for the green shell jump, just minimize your slow fall and try to aim again for the core. That's the big takeaway here. Sawrfing Castle, all about surfing on saws. And the big takeaway again, just use the core. To quote an old meme from Gradius, shoot the core. Aim right there. Minimize slow fall here and catch up with the saw if you're a little bit behind, because you really do have a lot of room to catch it over here. And then you can just either wait and surf on over and pop over, or just try to aim for this diagonal. And if you do all that, well, gosh golly, you just might get the orb. Thanks for watching, and in the next video, I will talk about the mushroom strats that you could use to save a little bit of time here. Peace.